upper airway tissue obstruction can occur from a deviated nasal septum, which is the cartilage that runs up and down the middle of the nose, or enlargement or hypertrophy of the turbinates, which are these ridges that occur within the nose. Some patients will have a droopy, soft palate, which is this structure in the back of the throat. The uvula is often enlarged. That's the little punching bag that occurs in the back of the throat. The tonsils can be enlarged. And the tongue is often enlarged. When the tongue is often enlarged, it may come up to as high as here. The soft palate may droop down to as low as here, and you may have very little opening in the upper airway. From the side view, this structure drops down like so, creating a blockage in your airway. In addition, in patients with an overbite, where the lower jaw is set back, the tongue is then pushed into the airway, further compromising the obstruction in the airway. If there are lesions on the vocal cords, they may also obstruct the airway. I'm Dr. Ronald Popper, Medical Director of the Southern California Pulmonary and Sleep Disorders Medical Center in Thousand Oaks, California. To view more videos to help address all of your questions about sleep apnea and other sleep disorders, please view our website at sleepmd4u.com. Thank you for watching, and always remember, sleep well tonight for a better day tomorrow.